जय गुरुदेव चिल्ड्रन बेटा, वी वर लर्निंग एक्सरसाइज 5.2 इन प्रीवियस पीरियड एंड अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 वी हैड कंप्लीटेड। टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 एंड दिस इज ए पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2। सी दैट 2/3 टू द पावर 5 डिवाइड बाय 2/3 टू द पावर 4 इंटू 2/3 टू द पावर 3। सो वट इज अवर क्वेश्चन? सी दैट 2/3 टू द पावर 5 डिवाइडेड बाई 2/3 टू द पावर 4। अप्लाई द रूल इन दीज टू। ए टू द पावर m डिवाइडेड बाई, सी दैट बोथ द बेसिस आर इक्वल। ए टू द पावर m डिवाइडेड बाई ए टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर m माइनस n। इट मीन्स 2/3 टू द पावर ओनली। ऑलवेज सी दैट बेस शुड बी इक्वल। इफ बेस शुड बी इक्वल देन ओनली यू कैन अप्लाई दिस लॉ। ओके, 5 माइनस 4 इज इक्वल टू 2/3 टू द पावर 1। नाउ वट इज अलॉन्ग विथ, वी हैव सिंप्लीफाइड अप टू हियर। ओके, सो वट इज लेफ्ट इन प्लेस ऑफ दीज टू? नाउ वी कैन राइट दैट 2/3 टू द पावर 1 इंटू 2/3 टू द पावर 3। विच लॉ कैन बी अप्लाइड? ए टू द पावर m इंटू ए टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर m प्लस n। So it will become 2/3 to the power 1 plus 3 is equal to 2/3 to the power 4. It will be your answer. Okay. Now see that the B part of the same question. B part of same question now. See that 3 to the power 0 plus 4 to the power 0 plus 5 to the power 0. You know that a to the power 0 is always equal to 1. Now see that it means it will become 1 plus 1 plus 1. It will be 1 plus, because in place of this also we can write 1. Here also 1, here also 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, it will be 3 as your answer. Now come to the question number C part. Now see that 6 to the power, again apply same rule, a to the power 0 is equal to 1. A to the power 0 is equal to 1. So in for every, I mean whatever the greater number will be there, if its power is being 0, then its value will be equal to 1. Now write that here 1 plus 1 multiplied by 1. Okay, plus here 1 plus 1 divided by 1. Because for all the numbers having power 0, so it their values will be equal to 1. 1 plus 1, 2 into 1, plus 1 plus 1, 2 divided by 1. 2 1 ja 2 plus 2 divided by 1. 2 plus 2, 4 divided by 1 is equal to 1 4 ja 4. So it will be equal to 4. 4 upon 1 means 4. It will be, your answer will be 4. Okay, see that. Now next one. Now see that beta, what is your question? Minus 1/3 to the power 2 into minus 1/3 to the power 3 divided by minus 1/6 to the power 2 into minus 1/6 to the power 3. Here you just in one bracket you will apply one rule, or in another bracket you will apply another rule for that bracket. Okay, see that here it is a to the power, both of them having 1/3 as its base, so it can be written a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. Same rules will be applied here also in this bracket. Now see that what it will become? Minus 1/3 to the power how much? 2 plus 3 divided by minus 1/6 to the power 2 plus 3. Okay, so it will become minus 1/3 to the power 3 plus 2, 5 divided by minus 1/6 to the power 2 plus 3, 5. Okay, now come to the next one. Come to the next one. Now see that beta, here the powers are common and bases are different. So in this way, what rule can be applied? A to the power m divided by b to the power m is equal to a upon b to the power m. Means इफ देयर बेसिस आर डिफरेंस बट पावर्स आर सेम सो वी कैन राइट देम इन डिवीजन फॉर्म एंड पावर विल बी द कॉमन फॉर पावर कैन बी मेक एज कॉमन फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम ओके नाउ सी दैट व्हाट इट कैन बी बिकम विट व्हाट इट कैन बी माइनस वन अपॉन थ्री डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस वन अपॉन सिक्स टू द पावर हाउ मच फाइव बिकॉज फाइव पावर इज कॉमन फॉर देयर सो हाउ यू कैन राइट माइनस वन अपॉन थ्री अपॉन माइनस वन अपॉन सिक्स होल पावर फाइव नाउ सी दैट माइनस एंड माइनस विल बिकम कैंसिल सो व्हाट इट कैन बिकम वन अपॉन थ्री इंटू सिक्स अपॉन वन दिस विल गो इन द न्यूमरेटर ओके इन डिविजन फॉर्म वी आर राइटिंग दैट ओके इन रेसिप्रोकल फॉर्म डिवाइडेड बाय फाइव वन एंड वन विल बिकम कैंसिल थ्री टू जा सिक्स सो इट विल बिकम टू टू द पावर फाइव और टू टू द पावर फाइव मीन्स टू इंटू टू इंटू टू इंटू टू इंटू टू वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव इट विल बिकम इक्वल टू थर्टी टू एज योअर आंसर थर्टी टू एज योअर आंसर नाउ सी दैट द नेक्स्ट वन पार्ट सी दैट नाउ ई पार्ट माइनस सेवन होल पावर थ्री इंटू वन अपॉन माइनस सेवन स्क्वायर होल पावर थ्री ओके यू कैन सी दैट इट इज इन न्यूमरेटर एंड इट इज इन डिनोमिनेटर रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर ओके ए टू द पावर एम होल पावर एन इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर एम इंटू एन इट मीन्स माइनस सेवन टू द पावर टू इंटू थ्री इंटू वन अपॉन माइनस सेवन टू द पावर टू इंटू थ्री ओके नाउ सी दैट माइनस सेवन टू द पावर थ्री टू जा सिक्स इंटू वन अपॉन माइनस सेवन टू द पावर थ्री टू जा सिक्स सो व्हाट इट विल बिकम माइनस सेवन टू द पावर सिक्स अपॉन माइनस सेवन टू द पावर सिक्स both of them can be cancelled so it will become 1 it will become equal to 1 okay now come to the f part of same question okay 4 to the power 7 into 4 to the power 8 into 1 upon 4 to the power 9 See that now, how it can be solved. A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. So, make them 4 to the power 7 plus 8 into 1 upon 4 to the power 9. So, how much, in what manner you can write that? 4 to the power 8 plus 7, 15 into 1 upon 4 to the power 9. It can be written as 4 to the power 15 upon 4 to the power 9. Now apply the formula a to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n. It means 4 to the power 15 minus 9 is equal to 4 to the power 6. That will be your answer. That will be your answer. Now, come to the next question. See that now 3 to the power 9 into 1 upon 3 to the power 24. Okay. Apply the formula here. A to the power m divided by a to the power n because this is in numerator and this is in denominator so the division rule can be applied here is equal to a to the power m minus n now see that bases are equal to 3 to the power 9 minus 24 okay so it will become 3 to the power minus 13 3 to the power minus 13 सॉरी नॉट 13 बेटा 15 3 टू द पावर माइनस 15 सो 3 टू द पावर माइनस 15 विल बी योर आंसर ओके नाउ कम टू द सी दैट द नेक्स्ट वन व्हाट इज दैट एच पार्ट सी दैट नाउ एच पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन सी दैट माइनस टू टू द पावर सिक्स होल पावर टू ओके इट मीन्स ए टू द पावर एम होल पावर एन इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर एम इंटू एन इट मीन्स माइनस टू टू द पावर सिक्स इंटू टू इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू टू द पावर सिक्स टू जा ट्वेल्व इट विल बी योर आंसर सो इन दिस वे बेटा आई एंड जे पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन विल बी योर होमवर्क आई पार्ट इज सेम एज द डी पार्ट ओके एंड जे पार्ट इज द कम्बिनेशन ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ द पार्ट एज आई डिड इन द दिस क्वेश्चन एंड इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड अप टू हियर देन यू विल नॉट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम टू डू दीज टू पार्ट सो दीज टू पार्ट्स यू विल परफॉर्म योर सेल्फ नाउ कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड बेटा कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड एंड अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग यू दैट प्लीज बेटा लर्न ऑल द आइडेंटिटीज वट एवर आई हैव गिवन टू यू Without identities, you will not be able to solve this chapter. Okay? So, be focused on your identities. Then only you can understand and you will be able to solve the chapter. Now, come to the question number third, beta. See that now. What is the question? Minus 1 to the power 4 into minus 1 to the power 7. Solve this left hand side first. A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. See that their bases are equal to minus 1. Okay, so it will become minus 1 to the power 4 plus 7 is equal to minus 1 to the power p. Okay, beta. Now see that minus 1 to the power 4 plus 7, 11. Is equal to minus 1 to the power p. I am adding one more formula where I have written the formulas. Okay. One more law I am going to add there and you will also note down that law also there because that is very important for you. 5th, 6th. Okay. 7th I am adding here. I am having space and in your copy also you will also have space there. So write that if any question is like that a to the power m is equal to a to the power n till here it was in multiplication or addition or subtraction form now if it is like that a to the power m is equal to a to the power n means their bases are equal but the powers are different in this case always m will be equal to n m is always equal to n now see that here we are going to write minus 1 a to the power m is equal to a to the power n it means m is equal to n you see that a means both of them having minus 1 and minus 1 as equal to their bases so m what is the value of m in this case 11 is equal to in place of n what is their p In place of n, what is there? P. See that, well, 11 is equal to P. It means P will be equal to 11. This will be your answer. This will be your answer. Okay. Now, see that B part of this question. See that, beta. What is the question now? 1 upon 8 to the power 6 divided by 1 upon 8 to the power 5. First, solve left hand side. A to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n. A means, what is the base? A means base. What is base here? 1 upon 8. 1 upon 8 to the power. M means 6. N means 5. 6 minus 5 is equal to 1 upon 8 to the power 1. Now, if you will see that left-hand side completely we have solved and we got in place of left-hand side. Now, what we can write 1 upon 8 to the power 1. Now, see that 1 upon 8 to the power 1 is equal to 1 upon 8 to the power 1 minus p. Now, see that इफ ए टू द पावर एम इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर एन इम्प्लाइज दैट एम इज इक्वल टू एन. ओके नाउ सी दैट ए टू द पावर एम, ए मीन्स 1/8, हियर ऑल्सो 1/8. नाउ पावर्स आर डिफरेंट, इट मीन्स पावर्स विल बी इक्वल इन दिस केस. इट मीन्स 1 इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस पी. ओके नाउ यू ब्रिंग दिस माइनस पी हियर, इट विल बिकम प्लस पी इज इक्वल टू दिस 1 विल रिमेन हियर एंड दिस 1 विल गो ऑन माइनस दैट्स ऑन शिफ्ट ऑन माइनस ऑन राइट हैंड साइड इट विल गो माइनस 1. सो पी इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस 1 0. सो पी विल बी इक्वल टू 0 एज योर आंसर. पी विल बी इक्वल टू एज योर आंसर, हेंस पी इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ सी दैट सी पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन बेटा. 5 टू द पावर 4 इंटू 5 टू द पावर 8. 5 टू द पावर 4 इंटू 5 टू द पावर 8 इज इक्वल टू 5 टू द पावर 3p. 5 टू द पावर 3p. नाउ सी दैट हियर बेसिस आर इक्वल, सो अप्लाई द मल्टीप्लिकेशन आइडेंटिटी फॉर द एक्सपोनेंट. ए टू द पावर m इंटू ए टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर m प्लस n. इट मीन्स 5 टू द पावर 4 प्लस 8 इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड विल बी एज सेम 5 टू द पावर 3p. 4 प्लस 8 12. 5 टू द पावर 12 इज इक्वल टू 5 टू द पावर 3p. नाउ सी दैट ए टू द पावर m इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर n. इट मीन्स m इज इक्वल टू n. ओके इफ बेसिस आर इक्वल, यू कैन सी दैट हियर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड राइट हैंड साइड बेसिस आर इक्वल. सो व्हाट इज द पावर ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, दैट इज 12 इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड पावर इज 3p. सो 12 अपॉन 3 इज इक्वल टू p. 3 4 जा 12, 4 इज इक्वल टू p. इट मीन्स p इज इक्वल टू 4 विल बी योर आंसर. p will be इक्वल टू 4 एज योर आंसर. ओके Now the D part and E part of this question, I am leaving for you as your homework. D and E, do as your homework and show me, okay? And how you have to show, you already know that how you will show me, okay? Now come to the beta question number 4th. Okay? And see that what is the question number 4th now. See that now. State whether true and false and justify your answer. 20 to the power 6 into 20 to the power 11. Apply the law here. A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. Okay. Now apply. It will how much it will become? 20 to the power 6 plus 11. Is equal to 200 to the power 17. See that 20 to the power, powers are being equal. 11 plus 6 17 here, but here left hand side is 20 and right hand side is 200. It is 200 to the power 17. Bases are not equal, whether the powers are same, so how they can be equal? They can't be equal. So in this way it will not equal, and that's why the statement will be as false statement. Statement will be as a false statement. Now see that the B part. See that he is asking whether 2 to the power 5 is greater than 5 to the power 2. See that now. How we will do? 2 to the power 5 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Greater than 5 to the power 5 into 5. 2 to the 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16 to the 32 is coming greater than 25. So statement is true. 25 will be greater than 32 will be greater than 25. Hence the statement is coming as beta true. Now come to the C part of this question. Same question. Okay. See that now what is the is given in that one. इट इज गिवन दैट 5 to the power 3 इंटू 3 to the power 5 इज इक्वल टू 15 to the power 15। बेटा 15 to the power 15 विल कम अ ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू, इट विल बी अ ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू एंड इफ यू विल सॉल्व इट, इट विल नॉट कम दैट मच ऑफ ग्रेटर। सो इन दिस वे दिस स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स। सो हाउ वी कैन राइट दैट 15 to the power 15 विल कम ग्रेटर देन 5 to the power 3 इंटू 3 to the power 5, हैंस द स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स। Hence the statement is false because it is not possible to solve that 15 multiplied to the 15 times. It will be very difficult to multiply that. By observation only we can write the answer. Okay. Now come to the question number D part of the same question. Just now I taught you that you have given 3 to the power 0 is equal to 500 to the power 0. I taught you that a to the power 0 is equal to always 1, means if any number, whether the number having the greatest value, if its power is given equal to 0, then means what will be your answer? Equal to 1. Equal to 1. Whether the base will be as much of as greater it can be. But if it is its power is being 0, then your answer will be always equal to 1. Now see that 3 to the power 0, 1 is equal to 500 to the power 0 is also equal to 1. Okay, so in this way they are coming equal, left hand side and right hand side. So statement is true. Statement is true. Now come to the E part of this question. Okay, see that 1 upon 3 to the power 5 and whole power is given as 2 is equal to 1 upon 3 to the power 10. Okay, he is asking whether it will, they both will be equal or not. See that in left hand side a to the power m whole power n is equal to a to the power m into n. Okay, it means 1 upon 3 to the power 5 into 2. And right hand side what it will become? 1 upon 3 to the power 10. Now see that 1 upon 3 to the power 10 in left hand side also, and in right hand side also 1 upon 3 to the power 10. So the statement is true. Statement is true. Okay. Now come to the question number 5. See that now express the following as the product of prime factors. First of all, what we will do in this question, we will do the prime factorization. We have done this question earlier in exercise 5.1 also. And then we will write the answer in exponential form. So do the prime factorization for this question. First do for 100. Okay. Divide it by prime numbers. I am writing prime numbers. Many children still they are making mistakes. They are dividing by 4 and 9 or 6, like the numbers like that, the 4, 9 and 6 also. I taught you and repeated many times that they are not prime numbers. Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19 and so on. If you will divide by 2, it will be equal to 50. Still, if you will divide further by 2, you will get 25. Now it will not be divisible by 2. 5 ja 25 and 5 1 ja 5. Okay. And 64 now. Now see that 64 is equal to, do the prime factorization of 64. So it will be equal to 2, 32, then 2, 16, then 2, 8, then 2, 4 ja 8, 2 2 ja and 2 1 ja. So 100 into 64 is equal to, 100 can be written as 100. See that I am writing 100. Just now I have done prime factorization. 100 is equal to 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. It means 2 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 2. Okay. And now write 64. 64 is equal to 2 into 2 इंटू टू इंटू टू इंटू टू इंटू टू, टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स, इट मीन्स टू टू द पावर सिक्स. नाउ इफ यू विल राइट 164 टुगेदर, सो हाउ यू विल राइट, सी दैट 100 मीन्स टू टू द पावर टू इंटू फाइव टू द पावर टू, और 64 मीन्स टू टू द पावर सिक्स, सो यू कैन राइट दैट टू टू द पावर टू प्लस सिक्स इंटू फाइव टू द पावर टू, सो योर आंसर विल बी टू टू द पावर एट इंटू फाइव टू द पावर टू. मे बी एवरीबडी ऑफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड 2 to the power 2 and 2 to the power 6 we have added because their bases are same and the powers are different. So we have applied the rules a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. A to the power m plus n. So in this way, what answer you got? 2 to the power 8 into 5 to the power 2. Now see that one more part I am going to do, that is B part, 27 into 125. See that this one, 27 into 125. Okay, see that now beta, 27 means do its prime factorization, 3 9 ja, 3 3 ja and 3 1 ja. Same way for 125 also, 5 25 ja. 5 5 ja and 5 1 ja. So 27 into 125 is equal to 27 can be written as 3 into 3 into 3 or 25 5 into 5 into 5. So you can see that beta 3 into 3 into 3, 3 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 3. It will be your answer. It will be your answer. Now see that C part of this question, okay, and what is the C part? 729 into 1024. First I am doing prime factorization for 729. See that now 729 divisible by 3, 3 2 ja 6, 3 4 ja 12, 3 3 ja 9, 3 8 ja 24, 3 1 ja, then 3 27 ja, then 3 9 ja, then 3 3 ja and 3 1 ja. Okay, now write 1024 divisible by 3, 2 5 ja, 2 1 ja, 2 2 ja, 2 2 ja, 2 5 ja or 2 6 ja, 2 1 ja, 2 2 ja or 2 8 ja, 2 6 ja, 2 4 ja, 2 32, 16 2 ja 32, 2 8 ja 16, 2 4 ja, 2 2 ja and 2 1 ja. Okay, now see that beta, 729 can be written as, how you will do now, see it here. 729 into 1024. 729 is a product of 3. How many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Three into three. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1024 is a product of 2. But how many times we have to count it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Into 2, into 2, into 2, into 2, into 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into 2, into 2, into 2, into 2, into 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It means how many times 3? 3 to the power 6 into 2 to the power 10. What is 729 into 1024 can be written in exponential form as. So it is not difficult. Everybody of you can do this one also. So two more part of this question are there. So you will perform those part yourself. ओके सो अप टू हियर एक्सरसाइज 5.2 अप टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5th वी हैव कंप्लीटेड. सी दैट डी एंड ई पार्ट एज योर होमवर्क पार्ट. डी एंड ई पार्ट एज योर ओके सो कंप्लीट एज आई टॉट यू. जस्ट इनफ फॉर टुडे बेटा. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ गुड डे टू ऑल ऑफ यू.